Hi there, my name is Lou O'Neill. I wrote a poem, War Stories by a Gunship Pilot in a place called Vietnam. I went to the war 20 years after I had been in Vietnam, and I really didn't know I had carried any residue until I went to the war and I began sobbing. Shortly after, I wrote this poem, which kind of helped me find out some stuff. I'd like to read it to you. It's War Stories by a Gunship Pilot in a place called Vietnam. This is my Vietnam diary. Tregaskis wouldn't do. I had to write it down and hope to sing it too. I hear it in my head with Johnny singing clear. My name is Lou. How do you do? I am full of fear. When I was young, I played with guns. My mother called me Teddy. But no one really knew, they were getting little Louie ready. My nickname in the Corps was Louie the Rat. I never told my loved ones why they called me that. I started losing lots of friends back in 1955. Jumping into carrier jets was an easy way to die. There was a thing no one talked about. It's called the right stuff. It's a higher high for pilots, but we never get enough. If you're confused by what I say and what I think I did, it's because I don't remember all of it. There's much I'm sure I've hid. I'd like to flush it out of me, but I haven't done the job. Because too many times, I laugh and laugh, and then begin to sob. I left behind a treasure, an unknown kind of life. There were four beautiful children, and a very loving wife. They never knew I paid my dues. Life didn't mean a damn. I just wanted to be a hero in a place called Vietnam. A naked little boy with no ribbons on my greens. I did the only thing I knew to do by those Huey killing machines. Rough, tough, and hard to bluff, a United States Marine. Confusing the one inside of me, the one that's a human being. I was a gunship pilot in a place called Vietnam. I drank and flew two reckless tours. I knew that I'd be damned. I believed that macho saying that I was born to die. So I flew that Huey gunship through a mystic eastern sky. Yes, I was a gunship pilot in a place called Vietnam. I was taught and always bought what it takes to be a man. I flew over 1,000 missions just so I could say I can. But when I look into the mirror, I wonder who the hell I am. So many things to do in that place called Vietnam. We flew many kinds of missions. Do anything we can. We protect the young brave pilots who flew the medevacs. We'd insert those crazy recon kids and hope to get them back. I was a gunship pilot in a place called Vietnam. Emergency extract mission. Broke the ready room standby comm. Then we'd hear the fateful transmission, the one we all feared. The frightened call of the recon kid whispering, "Choppers were over here." The VC used to pound Da Nang with rockets every night. They moved through the mystic jungle, always out of sight. We comped short a big army searchlight, flew it on a Huey very high, while I flew low on the spotlight, certain I was gonna die. When I flew as an airborne observer, I'd fly low and go real slow. I had to see who were the VC. Did anybody know? You'd be called a fool in any flight school. This is not the way to fly, but it's my job to see, you see, who would live and who would die. Because in just a moment or two, I'd be bringing terror out of the blue. There'd be burning nape worse than rape of the horrible things it can do, along with other big boy toys made only to make people die. I would be the one that brought your fixed-wing son screaming from the sky. One time I volunteered, I thought I knew the job. Studies and Observation Group, a unit they called SOG. It turned into a suicide mission and they wanted us to go. This time I was a gunship pilot in a place called I don't know. You can't say no, you gotta go. You know you're gonna die. I had no God to pray to. My God was an obscure sky. Wake up all hungover, full of booze, beer, and fear. We were too far west, couldn't guess what country we were even there. There's a lot to see around the DMZ to that prison they call Nam. I haven't been to Folsom. I've done time in places like Khe Sanh. We've stayed the night with brave young grunts, hear stories full of fear. Young Marines killing VC, some bringing back an ear. I knew the cities would be different after a place called Vietnam. They've been crawling through the night jungles, fighting VC hand to hand. They know about guns and they know about fun. Now they're getting sore. Better treat them nice, that's my advice. You can't scare them anymore. The first thing you see in Khe Sanh, if you're lucky enough to land, was a painted sign on an ammo box stuck into the sand. It said, "Welcome to Khe Sanh." Hey, that doesn't sound too mean. Built by the Seabees, used by the Army, and protected by the Marines. There were many weeks in frontier towns like good old Dong Ha. Fly all day, drink all night, a life I loved by far. Con Tien was a pockmarked death hill, hard to resupply. We even escorted C-130s so they could drop goodies from the sky. Some young macho pilots made gun runs just for fun. Too many women and kids around. I got 3 girls and a son. I probably made a few myself, but that was not for me. Besides, I sold my blood in college. I knew blood wasn't free. I was a gunship pilot in a place called Vietnam. If I don't keep telling my story, I won't know who I am. I had to write it down and say it. This part is just for me. I'd like to hear Johnny Cash sing it, but we're both past 63. I was looking for old Uncle Sam in that place called Vietnam, but I found booze, bullets, and buddies, and I felt like Macho Man. Being a Marine Corps pilot was the center of my life. Oh, I forgot. 4 wonderful kids and a very loving wife. There is one war hero that I have never met. I hope he's alive and well. A proud North Vietnamese vet. He took on my 2 blazing guns while I heard my rockets moan. But he stood his ground and with a captured AA rhyme, he sent my co-pilot home. Now here's some verse, the very worst. It's been buried out of sight. It's the hardest for me to write. It happened over and over on burning outposts on a dark and frightening night. It was a medevac escort mission a few clicks south of Khe Sanh town. My gunship was loaded and heavy, and the RPM was surging up and down. The medevac choppers weren't on radio and really running late. There was fire, confusion, and chaos below. I decided I better wait. But the warrior on the ground was dying. It was going to be up to me. A heroic mission for a gunship, or join him in eternity. "Come in, medevac, goddammit," the radio man screamed and screamed. My decision is still imprinted on many a Vietnam dream. He's one of the 50,000. I don't even know his name. But each time I go on a visit, it always seems the same. I know he's carved somewhere on that beautiful big black wall. Tears I cry are for friends I lost, but the sobs, they're for that one unanswered call. I flew with many brave young pilots, but the one I loved the best, little Joe Sestere, the Brooklyn kid, who cheered up all the rest. Before I left, I tried to teach him everything I knew. Guess I didn't know it all, because he's the first I always cry for when I'm standing at the wall. I was a gunship pilot in a place called Vietnam. I've killed a lot of people. That's part of who I am. I've never told my story. I never had the heart. Now, some 30 years later, it still tears my head apart. I was a gunship pilot in that place called Vietnam. I wrote home to my children. My letters were a sham. I couldn't talk of the insanity. I just played their deadly game. None of us knew from nothing. Now, even Mr. McNamara says the same. I came back, but had pushed the throttle, used the bottle, gone way, way too far. My loving wife left me. I had riddled her with scars. There is no end to this story. I still live another life. I stopped my drinking. changed my thinking and got a new daughter and wife. It's hard to tell a story that's been soaked in alcohol, but these are my recollections. I haven't told them all. Everything that has happened is still inside of me. I've used these words to let some out so I can be what I'm to be. I'm still a gunship pilot in that place called Vietnam. It's not the place I live at, but it's still a place I often am. Will it ever end? Louie the Rat.